Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Great run so far. 14 streak. Having some silliness. That is not going to be a lost run, which is the most important thing that I care about. Judas. Judas is the fun lover, but the streak ender. We got 1M, 3M. Wolf! Crazy. I would not have anticipated that. Anyway. Judas has some amazing things going for him. Hey, he starts at 3 cents, facilitating the early purchase of a Spirit Heart to raise his survivability, or perhaps even the ability to get an arcade on the next floor. Not that he has enough HP to really... Oh, no. No. We got another Red Heart on the last room. Don't give up hope. One hit. Certainly not enough to ruin our hope. Big fan. Great pickup. That's going to protect us from a little bit of damage, but I'll admit, I'm very concerned about the fact that we have a big room coming up next. It is not the most asshole-ish of big rooms. All we need to watch out for here is the bomb spiders. Don't get fucking destroyed by the bomb spiders. If we can stay away from the bomb spiders, life will be good, and we got small rooms on either side. The big fan pickup for our immediate survivability does nothing at all. But for our long-term, you know, viability on this run might be essential. I was going to say quintessential. The word needs to be retired. We use it too much because I think it sounds silly. But it doesn't get the job done in most. Quintessential. Just say stereotypical instead. We all know what that one means. Quintessential is like some old English bullshit. It's like some antiquated Latin phrase. Is no longer strictly necessary. I was very scared to actually stand right where we stood, but I, you know, worked it out of my noggin hole, and I decided that it should be okay. We're basically just gonna go wherever there's open space. If there's open space, we're gonna go there, because these guys can jump so far that I want to stay as far away as possible. We haven't picked up any scents, or, to be fair, any consumables of any kind over the rest of this floor. Now, all that really scares me here is the haunt. That key pickup is nice. It's the haunt, man. And it's Pin. Okay, so the fact that we're fighting Pin is awesome. Now, you know, we've tackled one problem. Now, we get an HP upgrade or some Spirit Hearts or Magic Mush. And we got Placenta. Okay. Truth be told, that should sort out... I mean, I'm not going to call it a one run yet. But that should sort out the problems that normally cause a Judas run to go belly up early. You know, with some HP... I have a little bit more leeway to be a little bit more aggressive, which might not necessarily be a good thing, but it's a good thing for us overall that we no longer have to, you know, worry about the fact that if we take damage against one enemy, we're possibly completely screwed. Now, with one key, there is a temptation, of course, to make sure that we go to our shop and buy a Spirit Heart, but I'm probably just going to go to our item room instead. Book of Belial guarantees us a deal with the devil anyway. So what am I trying to get out of a Spirit Heart? Well, I guess just survivability. Do I think I'll need that survivability? Probably not. It's a little bit risky. I mean, you can see I'm using my big fan shield here as an offensive weapon, so I'm still not balling out of control on damage by any stretch of the imagination, but that extra key helps a lot. Strange Attractor is not necessarily good. I picked it up kind of on a whim there. I don't regret it. No regrets, but... I'm a little concerned about how this might impact us in the future. Yes, of course. Apparently doesn't seem to be affecting those flies at all. Look, there's probably like 0% chance we end up getting out of this room. Could you? I don't think we can get it. Sorry, 0% chance we end up getting out of this floor without having to go to that big room. I would love it if maybe there was a path down. Nope. Oh, don't tease me. Don't tease me like that. That's not fair. Might be able to use Book of Belial right here. To do some extra damage without actually costing ourselves anything in the long run. Like, we might still be able to use it against the boss, but just to be safe, I'm not going to. Not just safe, but also good practice for the future. I didn't know there were two of you left. Ah, nice, okay. Another big room right after scares the shit out of me. So, obviously, if there's anything on this floor that gives us the ability to fly, like, if there's a deal with the devil, even if there's a choice between... a flying option and a non-flying option, we're going to be heavily incentivized to take the flying option as a result of the fact that it's, you know, right there. We got all stats upgrade. It's hard to justify not taking an all stats upgrade or not taking an item that facilitates the gain of an all stats upgrade at some point. Again, it doesn't really matter if we take damage. I would obviously prefer not to, but if we end up taking a hit or two, it doesn't really make a big difference as long as we just live through the process, because we do still have Book of Belial. So our deals with the devil are guaranteed, which is why you love Judas, and we've gotten out of the awkward period where Judas has no HP, so all things considered, things are going pretty well right now. Strange Attractor accepted. Accepted or accepted, I'm not totally sure which one I want to go with yet. So I think that was a pretty good use of Big Fan there. Again, the damage that we take on this room probably fairly unlikely to matter, so I'm totally getting up in their face with it, doesn't matter. Torn Photo, a great DPS upgrade. And I fucking hate my life. How do we do it? How do we do it? How do we do it? We gotta buy a spirit heart, but we don't have anything to buy. We can't buy a spirit heart, though. How am I supposed to buy a spirit heart? I need to get in there. Oh, I'm already feeling the power of Torn Photo, by the way. We need to get, like, another penny somehow, and then buy a spirit heart, and then buy the... or then get Spirit of the Night, but I can't get this. Please tell me there was not a... there's a red heart there. We're gonna hurt ourselves, then go to the boss rush room, and then try to get it. If we walk into that room, will the deal with the devil even still be there? I don't know. Is there even any way to still hurt myself on this floor? I don't know. My sunshine has been fucking stolen. Where's Len when you need him? Probably lying on the grass a Sunday morning of last week. L-A-T-E-R that week. I guess we're just gonna have to go. Oh, we could hurt ourselves here, actually. So I really doubt that we're gonna be able to get our deal anyway. Oh, it's still there. It's haunting me. One little voice is haunting me, haunting me. Anyway. Don't die, for fuck's sake. Don't die in your boss trap room here. But consumables? 1 cent. Oh, we got a spirit art! That's even better. Okay. That's exactly what we need to direct. Now, my hope is that, first off, it would be awesome to get another penny when we finish this room as well. But if we can just get back into that room, get Spirit of the Night, we'll walk the fudge out with a halo as well. So we basically get Spirit of the Night, half price, because we get the HP back. And then we get the tiers upgrade and the range upgrade and the damage upgrade and the other stats upgrade. It's all great. Okay, we should be a little careful about our HP because we do still need the Spirit Heart to exist if we're going to take this. But it's a weird situation where after we take the deal, we should be totally fine. All right, we got nothing else. Ugh. Ugh. Please be still open. I need this halo. Don't fuck with me like this. The game made it possible. Let's make it happen. Huge pickup also gives us Deal with the Devil precedent. We're holding Book of Belial. Make it happen. Yes. Now, don't get hit by the spikes on your way out of this room. Okay, good. You did it. Well done. Then we go pick up the halo. And that's a really good floor. We kept Deal with the Devil precedent. We got an all stats upgrade. Our HP is still okay. Strange Attractor. You know, not that amazing. Or even possibly terrible. But we also got Torn Photo out of the situation, so we're looking pretty good. We do, you know, we've sunk ourselves back into that situation that Kane starts with, where he has low HP, though. So we got to pick up some Spirit Hearts, which really, we just need money to solve that problem. And, you know, more keys wouldn't hurt either, I guess, but... Torn Photo plus the Halo is a pretty nice DPS upgrade for a single floor. You know, not even quite the same level as, like, even one Proptosis or something like that, but it's a help. It's a help for sure. And I'm starting to think that, you know, the groundwork has been laid for us to put up yet another victory, which would be awesome. Not quite unprecedented, but except for one precedent, it's unprecedented. And that's pretty good. I will say that, can I just get something that makes our tiers either red or large? Even if it doesn't actually give us a statistical benefit, it would give me a nice morale boost. Because right now I'm looking at our tiers and I'm like, eh, you know. They're doing a lot of damage, and I'm firing. Well, they're doing a decent amount of damage, and I'm firing them very quickly. But they're lacking a little oomph in the oomph department, you know? They don't quite have the chutzpah. They don't quite have the je ne sais quoi. that they need. Needs a little bit more potency, you know? It's better to look good than to feel good, Tears. Unfortunately, by taking that, I now can no longer access that room, but we have a red heart that we should be able to get, and I'm super stoked that we got a health upgrade to begin with. Now, let's try not to die on this room. That would be devastating. We got another key. We'll definitely pick that up. Yeah, okay. And this was a terrible decision. But on the... where did it just fly outside of the room or something? On the bright side, by getting Bob's Rotten Head, that means we won't get Bob's Rotten Head in the future, which means our next golden chest, it's probably Fate or Infamy. It's just science. You know what? I made a terrible decision. Don't talk about that. I made a terrible decision. By picking up Bob's Rotten Head and getting rid of Book of Belial, I think I lost my Book of Belial impact for this room. It's not going to be the difference between life and death, but it is the difference between, you know, finishing this room in a timely fashion and not finishing this room in a timely fashion. I was going to say, he was getting a little too close for comfort there. I'm recognizing right now, I'm not tilting, but I'm thinking that I'm doing more damage than I actually am. That has to be rectified. This room could have killed me. Either two hits from the keepers or just, like, accidentally walking on the spikes. So, I'm actually very, very happy that we managed to pull ourselves out of what seemed to be, you know, maybe calling it a downward spiral isn't fair, but I was a little nervous. Don't love the idea of fighting these guys without, with Strange Attractor. Or without full HP, I guess. Let's go to the item room first. Shops have a tendency now to not have keys. Maybe not 100% tendency, but high enough to be annoying. Book of Belial is back. Demon Baby's nothing to sneeze at. Not necessarily a game winner in and of itself, but for free without costing any hearts, I'm not going to complain. Yet another key. That'll be access to our shop. Probably. I don't believe that the husk can kill me in one hit. And if the husk has to hit me twice, that's tough luck, man, because I don't know if that's ever happened. He can get me once in a lot of situations. Twice would make me feel real bad. Tears up, shot speed down. Not an enormous problem. Okay, I guess we stop shooting when Krampus does that attack because Strange Attractor unfortunately has the tendency to pull him into us there. We just stop shooting and get the fuck out of the way. Lump of coal, lump of coal, lump of coal. Yes, okay. We are still in what I would consider to be a troublesome situation. Tears are looking a little bigger. That's a big part of my, what's making my enjoyment happen here. You know what? We're not going to buy an item in here. I didn't even mean to buy that red heart, but we will. There's no, it's hard to wean yourself out of this, but there's almost no point in buying a spirit heart because we don't lose our deal with the devil precedent if we get hit anyway. Like if we lose red hearts, because we have Book of Belial. So, I don't think that paying more for the spirit hearts necessarily makes sense. I will use that death card 10 times out of 10. No question about it. The reason I didn't want to spend any more money and pick up like the Red Heart and the Spirit Heart is because I want to get a deal with the devil on the next floor. Not a deal with the devil, a blood bank. I told you! I'm not going to go to that big room. We've been to all our special rooms except for maybe a curse room. Let's just go. Our HP is doing a little bit better now, but we got to be wary still. I'll go to the curse room now. It's right next to us. And Gimpy is an extraordinary pickup, even if we won't be able to make use of it right now. I'm hoping that this actually, you know, our decision to not spend money on the last floor, I'm hoping that works out with a blood bank on this floor, because if it does, Gimpy might allow us to get an extraordinary payout. Like, if we could get the HP upgrade plus... I thought we'd get out of it. If we can get the HP upgrade plus, like, a couple of Spirit Hearts out of it, then we take whatever deal with the devil shows up, and we don't have to stress out about anything along those lines, and that would be awesome. As you can see, though, our damage is actually doing very well. I can't be mad about that. Now, I am going to take a little bit of a strategic play here, and we'll see if we can get a teleportation card that would work on Boss Rush. Two of Hearts is fine. Strength is fine. We'll take Two of Hearts. Technically, we don't have to choose only one, but Two of Hearts, if we're only going to take one, which realistically I am, is going to benefit us more than Strength on the Blood Bank, which I am hoping, not assuming, but hoping that this floor has. As of right now, though, this is going pretty well. I can feel myself stronger than I used to be. as a result of this extra damage. The bad trip is not so bad. If we have to, we can always pop the Two of Hearts card to get us back up there. We can even take one more hit in the process. But for now, I'm not sweating this, actually. It's a little bit less HP than I'd like to have at this point in time, but apart from that, pretty good. I'm gonna blow up this just for convenience's sake, and we're gonna definitely buy a starter deck and maybe get the Spirit Heart as well. Now that we got the extra nickel out of that. Starter deck's so good. Get Two of Hearts plus Two of Diamonds. Let's double our money and then buy this, and that gives us enough money to pick up something on the next floor. Or we could have picked up that... there's another key in there, I think. We could have picked up the key. Not that useful. I don't really feel that strongly about having picked up that Spirit Heart, considering we just picked up another two for free right there, but still. Now, compare the speed at which we're going to deal with this room to the speed at which we dealt with the last room of this exact kind that we had, and you'll probably understand why I'm feeling pretty good about our situation here. Battery, we should be using the items more than I'm using them. I guess we have to go back to the item room. I kind of blanked on the fact that we'd even visited it in the first place, but I'm going to go out on a super limb and call this a one run right now. What are the changes? The amount of kind of extraneous HP that we just picked up makes it almost inconceivable that we'll die. Bloody Lust can be amazing here if we find a blood bank. It makes it almost unbelievable that we would die in kind of an unprecedented situation here. And again, the case for there being a... we'll pick that up. That was very dumb. The case for there being a... maybe get a card out of this now, yeah. Two of Hearts, Two of Hearts. Beautiful. The case for there being a blood bank just keeps getting stronger and stronger. Because we can actually access that boss trap room. And these will all give us cards. Or give us cards and runes. So we have a great impetus to blow all these up. Two of Hearts, Magician. We'll use the Magician because it sucks. The Devil, it's decent. Strength, it's okay. Chariot. Chariot, Two of Hearts is really what we want for like blood bank purposes. Joker, okay. Why not use the Joker card right now just to see what we get? Obviously, we're going to get it after the boss fight anyway. To only get two Spirit Hearts out of that is a little disappointing. We got Devil, we got Strength, we got Two of Hearts. Chariot, Two of Hearts, I think, is our ideal blood bank composition. So we'll roll with that. We might have missed one pill, but it's okay. The Spirit Heart pickups are nice. Obviously, I wish that we got a little bit more out of them, but whatever. No blood bank. Still, in the future, the blood bank will exist. I promise you. Two of Spades. Actually, we're going to take this instead of the Chariot. Look, some people might say you should take that instead of the Two of Hearts card. At this point, it's splitting hairs. Neither of those necessarily has a huge gain or a huge loss relative to the other one. No nickels out of that there, but that's okay. Down to the next floor. We already went to that deal with the Devil via the Joker card. Don't freak out. It's okay. Definitely a little slower than we'd like to be if we're going to do boss rush here. Which I do think is actually a pretty viable strategy for us on a run like this, but we don't have a teleport card. Mind you, we're a little bit more likely to get one now that we've taken all the pills out of our rotation as a result of a starter deck. I mean, I guess telepills is a pill, but we know what the cards do. That was easy enough. Two of Spades, Strength. Man, why are you trying to give me a Strength card all the time? Dad, I don't want your Strength card. I'm my own man. Just thought you could do with the null stats upgrade for one room. Fuck off, Dan. I'm trying to set up my own life here without anybody's help because there's some kind of pride to be gained from that. Want to play life on hard mode, Dad? All right, Junior. Go fuck yourself. Okay. Taking a little bit of damage, getting a little bit ornery on this floor. Not blaming Strange Attractor. It's on me. Really thought there would be some specialness up here. That's okay. When do we use Two of Spades? The only time when you have to use... Basically, here's how I consider Two of Spades, to put it in a more teachable term. Two of Spades means either you double your keys, or you're never going to run out of keys as long as you hold it, because you can always just use it to gain keys. The only time it makes mathematical sense to pop Two of Spades, is when we're over two keys. We'll talk about that. If you're at two keys, it's mathematically the same. Because you get two keys from Two of Spades if you use it on zero. So I rarely make an effort anymore to pop Two of Spades below three keys. And of course, once you get above three keys, you want to, you know, get as many keys as you can to make the best use of it. It's kind of unfortunate that you know, Goathead shows up. Would have preferred some other items, but Bloody Lust is making it so that the more damage we take here, I guess I'm not that sad about it. But I kind of, I like to hold Two of Spades as just a guaranteed you're gonna have keys card. You know, it's good enough this way. I don't worry about min-maxing it so much as I worry about, you know, how is this functionally gonna help me? I would rather hold Two of Spades than pop it at four keys. Or, sorry, pop it at two keys to give us four keys. Because this gives us a guarantee that we'll never run out as long as we're holding it. We do want to go to our shop on this floor. And, of course, we're going to get a deal with the devil. And we're not going to get HP here, so this might be one of the very few kinds of deals with the devil where, unless it's an amazing item, we may actually want to hold off a little bit. We may want to say, you know what? We're going to keep our HP instead, because we do need a little bit of HP to keep the, you know, the trains running on time here. Rotten Baby is probably good enough. It's borderline, but it's a great familiar, so I'll take it with us. And we'll move back to our shop here, even if it does fuck up our boss rush chances. What are we looking for from our shop? Little late for theirs options. We might still pick it up, though. We might pick up the tarot card just on the off chance that it's temperance, so we could use Unicorn Horn effectively on this floor, because we're not going to take it with us. Apart from that, I guess we'll just have to cross that bridge when we come to it. I don't want any of the candles, although we could replace our spacebar item. Like, we could replace Book of Belial. The question is, do I want to replace Book of Belial? The answer to that question, in most situations, is no, and this situation is one of those situations. Probably could have bombed our way in here. I honestly don't think Remote Detonator's worth it, but we'll take our card, and we'll take our key. And the card was the Hero Font, so that was definitely an awesome pickup. And we took our key as well. Just gonna stay as far back as we can, since these guys can't shoot. And there's another key. So if we get another key on top of these, we'd probably start to think about maybe using Two of Spades. Two of Hearts has been totally fucking worthless so far, so wouldn't be that big of a deal. Wonder where our secret room is. Could it be in this room back here? No. Well, you know what? I'm not going to look for it then. You had your chance. I'm going to look for it. Because we might be able to get this skull in it as well. Hey! We didn't get the skull, but we did get the secret room. And a greed fight is actually fine. You know, the money doesn't bother me. Counterfeit penny. I mean, we should pick up counterfeit penny while we pick up the rest of the money. Then we'll go with Liberty Cap. I still think this is a great situation. We have missed out on boss rush, barely, but we missed out on boss rush. That's just fine. As long as we can keep stacking up a little bit of damage floor over floor, and really, an IV bag would be awesome to help that. IV bag, I might consider getting rid of... Oh my god, has my mouse pointer been there, like, forever? I'm so sorry if it has. I might consider getting rid of Book of Belial for IV bag now that we have Bloody Lust and Goathead. The number of situations in which that will be a viable option for you... Not as Samson, or they've got to be like basically nil, but we're in one of those very strange situations, so I'll cop to it. I think it's an okay setup for us. These guys should be very easy to kill with our setup as well. Please, a blood bank on this floor. We got Black Candle, one of my favorite passive shop items, actually, and we'll pick up a Spirit Heart as well, and we'll pick up our key. If nothing else, it makes it so we can finally use Two of Spades. We did see a curse room over there. The guppy chances are not very high, but we'll still go to our curse room regardless. I would love to be able to go to our boss trap room as well. They don't normally have good items, but sometimes they'll surprise you. Joker? I don't even know why I would even want the Joker that much, come to think of it, but Two of Diamonds. All right, we'll pop that right away, because there's no incentive to hold on to that. We got the whole suite almost, except for Two of Clubs. Which would also be useful, you know? Apparently we're not balling out of control on any consumable here. Whipworm is okay, but Liberty Cap, a little bit more functional, which is better for us right now. Two Black Hearts. I can more than live with that. Easy enough. Goat Hoof? Again, it's okay. Not that useful. Maggie's Bow. Makes it a lot harder to stay at a two-heart interval, or sorry, a half-heart interval. Maybe even borderline impossible if we get off of it in the first place, but nice compass. It's good to have just for the extra HP, because I am, you know, hoping to pick up extra damage, and the easiest way for us to pick up extra damage with Book of Belial slash Goathead is going to be for us to basically luck into it by... Oh, there is a blood bank on this floor. Luck into it by getting a good deal with the devil. We will never speak of that damage ever again. I think I have a theory that, you know, I just have to take damage like that every now and then, or I forget that I'm myself. So don't think of that damage as bad. It was actually just maintenance damage to help me do better in the future. I promise. So no demon judgment, unfortunately. Any payout here? IV bag would be fine. I made a terrible mistake and should have used two of hearts earlier. That's what happens when you hold on to this shit forever. We're gonna play this guy for a while to get like one red heart back. We only need one red heart. I could blow you up and probably get it. So, you know, no pressure, but seriously, you should probably pay out sooner. You know, there's gonna be hell to pay. Yeah, I really appreciate the money. It's not like that's what I'm putting in the first place. You know, if I had it, I wouldn't be... If I didn't have it, I'd probably not be putting it into the machine right now. I mean, you're giving me a lot of it. I guess I appreciate that, but maybe you can give me literally any other kind of consumable in the known world. No, just more nickels and dimes, yours and mine. Okay, yeah, if you want to quote Third Eye Blind, I'll be here all day for you, but maybe you could pay out with a heart in the meantime so I can continue to survive. You know what? You lost your chance. You lost it. I don't even know what I'm going to play this guy for. Yeah, there we go. He realized what was good for him pretty quick. Are we going to... We're on the final floor here. I think we can just pop two of spades and then roll with this devil card in the future. Mysterious chocolate's not that good. I am looking for a good trinket, though. Live to die. Placenta healed us a little bit. I guess we just have to take our time gambling and then Placenta will bring us back here. Actually, we should probably... Two of clubs. We should probably get into our boss trap room before we get the regen again. And then there's a lot of red hearts just sitting around. Certainly, yeah, we've buffed ourselves up here by taking so much damage. Bloody Lust is actually going to be super useful now. It already is great, but I'm happy to have it be even better. Joker card. I mean, we'll just pop it because we can. I like my damage too much to take Bloody Lust. I like my Book of Belial damage. I'm sorry. I know, you might be saying, you can take it, you can still get the deal with the devil. And it really is only one deal at this point, but you can still make that happen with your unicorn horn. Oh, Maggie's bow healed us a little too much there. I know, but this is what I'm going to choose to do here. I like the damage bonus from Book of Belial more. Oh, thank you, Gimpy. I was waiting for that for a long time. When we finally got it, I didn't know what to do with it. It's a metaphor for a lot of things in a young boy's life, I think. More money, no IV bag. You know what? If they don't want to give me IV bag, I'm content to not take IV bag. We can roll with Book of Belial. I'm happy to have gotten the damage bonus for this floor. We already have the HP cap, so I'm not going to worry a little scary there. I'm not going to worry about bombing those things, those fires to get any extra deliciousness in the form of spirit hearts or whatnot. Yeah, our damage is actually pretty awesome right now, and the flies are helping out too. Does suck that this is going to be our last deal with the devil. Might as well get that bomb. This isn't our last deal with the devil, but we already know what's in it, so our next deal with the devil is our last deal with the devil. Apologies for the confusion there. Means that our chances of becoming Guppy are basically nil, and if we really want to knock it out of the park with a super, super, super high damage run, pretty much the only way that we're going to be capable of doing that is by... Yeah, pretty much the only way that we're going to be capable of doing that is by getting a crazy good item on Womb 1. Hopefully not XL. Mm-hmm. Alright, so with the compass, we can see what we're doing. I'm not relying on Gimpy to give me any HP, so the curse room is... I don't know, a bit of an outside shot, although we can fly. I guess since we can fly, it's only a one cost anyway. Gimpy wouldn't give us HP because we won't take a hit on the way in. Might be worth it, though. You know, contract from below, mark, pact. Guppy's tail, Guppy's collar. 9 lives might not be that useful for me right now, but it could just give me spirit hearts as well. Or it could give me fucking spiders. You know, spirit hearts are spiders. That's the name of the game. I've always said it. You know, is she coming up spirit art? She coming up spiders? Tough luck. Maybe the next red chest will do it for you. Two of clubs. Shouldn't... I mean, there's no reason to pop it right away. But the reason I do it is because laziness, and also because we're really probably doubtful that we're going to need more than 20 bombs in the future. So Teratoma, with our strange attractor, is going to be a little bit of a dangerous thing, because we're going to be pulling spiders and all sorts of other riffraff towards us, but they're also getting pulled towards the bullets, so ended up working out. We will totally take the HP, because why not? And honestly, here, I think we take nothing. If it was Guppy's Paw, Whore of Babylon, I'd be all over it. And if that was a Guppy item, I'd be all over it. But because they're not, I think we're better off just fucking leaving. Unfortunately, I wish it was different. But it's not. So on this floor, we will take the opportunity to gamble a little bit to get the damage bonus. Also hoping that, Gimpy comes around for us and pays out. It did not. But remember, every red heart heals us for double. And there is a small chance we can get IV bag. Whether or not we want it is a different thing altogether. But that's probably our full damage bonus on this floor. Additionally, we can get to our boss trap room. Don't make me regret not taking Guppy's head. But I'll go to you regardless. When the feeling's right, I gotta run all night. I gotta run to you. And that's what I'm gonna do. Well, I mean, I'm probably like saunter. More of a cool guy pose anyway. I think Placenta healed us. So I can't go back in there. It had to be Placenta, because anything else would have done... Like, if we picked up a heart by accident, it would have done one full heart, so... That's, unfortunate, I guess. But hey, now we got maybe even more of a damage bonus. If we weren't at the max before, we'll be at the max now. Probably. Yeah, we'll open these. Bible Tract. Again, yet another, acknowledgement that I need to fully learn what that trinket actually does. I don't think it... Well, at this point... Who cares if it gives us Deal with the Angel? I would like a Deal with the Angel. We'll say yes to Bible Tract on the off chance that it gives us more HP, which I think it may. And as you can see, even without Book of Belial actually working on this room, we did quite a number on the enemy. I don't think there's any reason to play the Blood Bank anymore. I don't think we need IV Bag. Although, to some extent, there's no reason not to play it as well. It's a complicated situation. Would we want IV Bag? With Maggie's bow, it seems like IV Bag is twice as useful. But is twice as useful IV Bag plus Bloody Lust as good as just Book of Revelations? Or sorry, Book of Belial to begin with? I don't know. I think we've probably got a good bead on a win either way. People say that outside of Canada? Don't take issue with that. If it's actually like a legitimately... It used to be an American or a Dutch, I don't know, phrase before. I'm just trying to say what I know, and what I know is that I've heard people say that in Canada. Get a bead on it. It's like a marksman or something like that, I guess. Look, you can't convince me to gamble by saying that money equals power has a chance to show up. You could convince me to gamble on the Blood Bank by convincing me that the IV bag is better than Book of Belial in this situation. Mathematically. And I can understand the case for it, because Book of Belial I'm only using occasionally, probably less often than I should. Chariot's probably better than Strength in our situation. I guess we're just gonna move along. Should pop Book of Belial here. It's a case not necessarily of thinking that the other side in this case is wrong, more like the devil you know is better than the devil you don't. And I know Book of Belial, I can control it. I'm familiar with, you know, the bonuses that it's going to impart upon me, whereas IV Bag carries a little bit of extra inherent risk to it. We're going to head up to the next floor. I'm feeling like this is a win. This will be win 15, which is pretty amazing. And it's not like, you know, not every run has the chance for zany shit to happen. If playing the Blood Bank is the zaniest shit that you can find on a run, there's not that much zany shit to happen. It's not like we had any dice rooms or anything that I totally ignored, at least to the best of my knowledge. We have enough HP that, I don't really want to do this on this floor, but we have enough HP that if we start taking damage, we can get up to a decent damage bonus. Without, you know, finding ourselves literally... That was such bullshit. Fucking strange attractor, man. Without finding ourselves literally dead. If we get a damage bonus on this floor, you know, it's... It's something, maybe not necessarily a good thing. Maybe a crawl space? Getting pretty close to our boss. So, I'd say, you know... I fucking hate this. We probably only need... I shouldn't have taken Strange Attractor. See, that's what you want to talk about zaniness. I picked up Strange Attractor, no questions asked. I think we only need one... obviously, the more the merrier, but I think we only need one good item on the chest to be able to pull it out. The more the merrier, but Callus, I don't think, does anything for us in this situation, this late in the game. I got hit by that still? I popped the chariot thinking like I'd be able to get out of that situation. Big fan didn't do quite as much damage as I thought there. I guess we get the bonus of the temporary damage boost again. Man, this guy is getting moved around. I actually really dislike the fact that he is so mobile. But I like the fact that he gets slowed. That's going to make my life a little easier. And then just finish this shit off as soon as you conceivably can. I can't believe I got out of that without getting hit. Fucking Strange Attractor, man. Don't throw my streak for me, please. Strange Attractor, I trusted you. You were meant to bring balance to the run, not destroy it. Here we go. No left hand. Good. Not good. Potentially really good. This is actually a legitimate situation where Undefined might be the best choice for us. Yeah, okay. This is pretty much what I'm hoping for. This is Undefined actually helping, because we have enough keys to do a few runs of the chest. Now, we are going to lose Book of Belial in the process. That's a big loss. Oh, come on. Don't give me the fucking D4. Not that again. We're going to stick with Undefined, because it's a cooler choice and it's a better strategic choice. I'm not even going to reroll our run once, because I like it right now. We're going to stick with Undefined. Fuck it, we'll reroll it once. We won't lose Undefined. This shit on the ground won't get rerolled either. We got Epic Fetus, like, technology out of it. I don't know, man. This probably, I mean, it seems like it probably upped our damage substantially. So I guess I'll take a win there. When you D4 into a scum item, I don't know, and we got Guillotine and Lord of the Flies as well. When you D4 into a scum item, is that you being a scum, or is that you being a cool dude who's not afraid of crazy runs? I don't know. That's the situation we're in, though. I hope I get some kind of synergy that overrides it, because as of right now, we actually are, like, substantially more powerful than the enemies, and we've pretty much turned this into a one run by virtue of some crazy items that showed up, so I'm very appreciative of that. We also have the Relic, Dark Bum Sissy Longlegs, so we should absolutely kill Gluttony last. It makes sense to continue... Yeah, we'll pick this up. It makes sense to... Thank you. Makes sense to continue to try to use Undefined, though. Because if we can pick up... How are you still alive? If we can pick up another floor out of it, we'll just get more powerful and perhaps, you know, funnier as well. But, yeah, I mean, at this point, it's almost inconceivable that this run loses. I can't really imagine what it would happen to... Or what would have to take in order to make that happen. That Eternal Heart is probably meaningless. This is not the direction to go to get to our boss room, which I'm a little bit surprised with. And sadly, nothing really of worth over there. There's our boss. I forgot that we totally had the compass, but then it got re-rolled. And then how are we able to see this? It's certainly not the Liberty Cap. I have no idea. Might just finish this run. We'll see. If I get another Undefined charge, I'll use it. But otherwise, we'll see. Could be fun. But I don't know what synergizes with Epic Fetus that much anymore. Almost pegged myself, unfortunately, there. There you go. In both senses of the word. No Nuns Habit, apparently, on the reroll. Let's go fight the boss. Not doing quite as much damage as I thought. I thought I'd throw a bomb in there to see if we had, like, sad bombs or something. Does not appear so. A reroll at this point is actually a liability. Let's go for it, though. I mean, with Undefined, it feels like a damn shame to just finish a run. When we could make something sillier happen. But if this reroll doesn't pan out, then we're just going to leave. And I think that's a pretty good compromise, all things considered. I want a reroll as well, but I only want a reroll if it's functionally going to give us cooler items. And I don't think we're going to get cooler items on the reroll, but I'll be happy to be proven wrong if the case appears. All right, well, that is going to do it. I had a great time that run. There were a lot of times where that shit... Oh, never mind. We could do it. There were a lot of times where that run was quite scary. I shouldn't be giving the eulogy yet in case, you know, we do manage to come back from this. But, you know... Oh, first off, I'm an idiot because I shouldn't be doing this room in the first place. But first off, thank you guys for all the support on these episodes. Not just the ones that have come over the course of this, you know, miniature streak, but also the ones that have, you know, we're on like 300 and something silly, like 6 or 7 right now. Maybe even higher than that. You know, thank you so much for the support on the series in general. It's absurd. I'm just happy to be here, basically. I'm still a kid who's like, you know, just super excited by the fact that I get to do this every single day, and the fact that people watch, even if they complain a little bit. I know that most of those complaints come from a place of love, even if you're rude about it. I hope you don't treat your mothers like that. We're doing this floor again. I don't know if ceremonial robes helps, but I assume that it does. There we go, we're looking for sad bombs. Why even take super bandage here? But sad bombs might work with epic fetus. And maybe we'll get like another, that could mean like another 7 chances to use undefined, right? Like, That might just have worked out perfectly enough that we get to keep going back and forth here. There's Humbling Bundle. We're out of keys, though, so we need Bombs or Key. Don't Telepills out, though. Oh, come on. Bad trip. Tears up. Health up. Bad trip. Telepills. Puberty. Bad trip. Range down. Telepills. Bad trip. So I guess we're going, but we need to get more keys if we're going to make use of this. We can probably get it. Alright, Curse of the Unknown. Can't see our HP. Pick up Charm of the Vampire, and pick up Robo Baby 2.0. Alright. Run's getting a little silly. Probably should not hurt yourself like that if you can avoid it. That might not be clear. Either we need more keys, which actually with Humbling Bundle is a pretty good chance to happen, or we need Bombs or Key Pill, or we need the lockpick, the paperclip, whatever you would like to call it, whatever its real name is. Or Flat Penny would have been awesome there. Dark Bomb, don't ever take my red hearts again. You're not welcome in this establishment anymore. We don't need that. We will still be using Undefined as much as possible, just because if it gives us, like, regular chests, or it's giving us, because it's the same every time. The secret room is, or the error room is the same every time. So it gives us a, oh nice. It gives us a free item. So we should always try, because one free item, hey, that's better than nothing, right? I don't know if anti-grav works with Epic Fetus. I'm gonna guess not. Does not appear so. That's a devil card, nothing to sneeze at. There's so much red on the ground that I can barely see what the hell I'm even doing here. More keys. That's huge. And we're going to get Tammy's head. Does it work with Epic Fetus? What? I don't know how to feel about this. We're going to head up to the next floor. But Tammy's head did seem kind of sweet. I didn't even see what was happening for a minute. All right, let's see what we get here. Piggy bank. Money equals power. Yeah, man. As long as we can keep getting stuff like this, I'm totally fine with it. Why are we blue? Oh, that's anti-grav, right. My mistake. Our damage should be out of control now. I mean, not that it isn't automatically as a result of just having Epic Fetus to begin with. Harlequin baby, Bob's brain. Yeah, sign me up. Usable items. A little ridiculous, the speed at which we're killing enemies here. Stay away from me, please. I'm not even doing anything, and it's still gonna die. So I don't really know what's happening there, but I appreciate it nonetheless. I can't get the pill. Health up. Why not? I mean, I guess there actually is a reason, but, you know. Why not, though? Think about it. Don't really need that, unless we get Flat Penny, in which case I'd be super stoked. And we would never run out of keys again. We could do the infinite Isaac run. Oh my god, Sad Bombs is doing the weird thing that I don't even understand the synergies of it, but it's kicking ass. I have no idea what it's doing, but I appreciate it nonetheless. Please die. All right, one hit, that's good enough. Apparently you're invincible there. Kind of willing to bet that a lot of people didn't necessarily know that you had invincibility frames in that period. We'll definitely take the pentagram, even with money equals power. We will take infamy. and we'll head down to the next floor again. Eventually this'll end, but it might take a little while. I hope you enjoy. We got a card there from our friend Regular Judgment. Actually, a couple of cards. So we got a speed plus range upgrade, Halo of Flies, oh, Bloody Penny. Unlikely to be that useful, I guess. Tears Up. What's this card? Chaos card. I think we've already got enough chaos for one run, but I appreciate it nonetheless. Our damage, again, we just picked up the pentagram, so it's going to be out of control. We need some more keys. That's definitely priority number one. Cage, one shot? No. Even a run of this magnitude is not capable of taking out the ridiculousness of the cage that quickly. Unfortunately. Almost took out the dark one in one shot. That's something to be proud of. I'm gonna try another, like, sad bomb. See what's up with that. What are these shots even doing? I have no idea. It's like some My Reflection, like, Cricket's Body homing tier shit. I almost wish we didn't get Epic Fetus, because it looks like our actual tiers would have just been hilarious. Alright, here comes Undefined again. Oh, we're totally gonna fight Mega Satan. There's no question about that. But before we fight Mega Satan, we should try to get another charge on Undefined. And then we'll fight Mega Satan. Just to have gotten it done on this run. Careful. Keys, please. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Like, we'll fight Mega Satan just to get a charge on Undefined, which is hilarious and ridiculous, and I love it. I might even want some more of it. What do I want pills for at this point, you know? I think we're pretty pilled out. I'm starting to run out of things to say. We're getting into, like, basement seed territory where I'm just like, you're like, what am I supposed to talk about? We're in the greatest position of all time. Six keys is lovely. We're doing such incredible damage that I don't even know what to say. I guess we're gonna go fight Mega Satan right now. Oh, we can't fight Mega Satan to get a charge on Dad's Key, of course. Of course. And then we'll use Undefined to teleport out after beating Mega Satan. I apologize, this is not meant as a bravado thing, this is just for fun. If you're having trouble beating Mega Satan, you haven't gotten that yet, don't take this as a slight. Don't take this as like, oh, Northern Lion's being an asshole. Nah, I'm not intending to be an asshole. Unfortunately, we can't have our cake and eat it too, which is my way of saying we can't take Undefined and fight Mega Satan. It's just not possible. I wish it were, but it ain't. Shit happens. I'm surprised that didn't hurt me. Oh, you know what? We can Chaos card here. Fuck you even using Epic Fetus. We hit him in the face. I guess you need a second Chaos card to take out a second phase. But the second phase is gonna be relatively easy, I'm assuming. I mean, we are doing, like, a stupid amount of damage. I'm assuming Bob's brain, if it hits, will do a ton of damage as well. Like, all those tears going back and forth. Normally, an enemy can only get hit by one bullet. Oh, but Mega Satan ends the run! I should have mashed the space bar there. I forgot that Mega Satan ended that run. That's on me. Oh, well. 15 win streak, ridiculous run. I hope you had a good time. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.